No, I wouldn't say that. It's definitely not a mentality you want to have. Each game presents its own challenges. Each team's showing a slightly different look. And in the last couple of games, we weren't happy with it. So we just want to try to impact the game in a positive way every single night.
Chris, we expect you to score these tip-ins and all that kind of stuff. That second one was something we haven't seen much of, just bursting down the speed and then Mika back in the pass. Can you just talk us through that a little bit?
I mean, that's something me and Mika have looked for, I think, the entire time we've played together, and it's not always there, but you know, when it is, he serves it up perfectly. It's something Laft started to look for, too, being our defenseman. You know, if there's an opportunity, just a worst-case scenario, hopefully I can get on the puck first at least, and we can get set up in the O-zone. But just a good way for us to kind of stretch out the D, and you know, occasionally it works out. So it was an unbelievable play by Mika.
I don't know whether this affected you or your line at all, but 11-7, is that weird for you guys? You know, does that have any effect at all on anything that you guys do?
Probably a different question. Probably a question for the centers, because we doesn't really change for the wingers. The centers were the ones who were double shifting a little bit, so I think more of a question for the centers and the defensemen. We're in a position where we're watching Mika as opposed to playing with him every shift, so especially there in the third when he was really double shifting a lot. Me and Laff were just talking about how good he is the whole time. just making such smart plays on the defensive side. I mean, you see his commitment to winning. We get up a few goals and he's not smelling blood in the water and looking for points. He's backtracking hard. He's making unbelievably smart reads and smart plays and really trusting his instincts. And I mean, when you've got a center like that, I mean, it's awesome to watch. It's awesome to play with.
Excuse me.
Sorry about that.
Maybe you're not overly concerned or too concerned at all with your personal points, but you do tie your career high, 53 so far. What's working? What do you feel has maybe contributed to your level of consistent production this year?
Team's playing well. Our play's been clicking. Playing with some unbelievable line mates and unbelievable defensemen every time I'm on the ice.
Thought on your goaltender tonight?
Sorry?
Thought on your goaltender tonight?
It's, honestly, I think you could go back 8 or 9 years and take some of the quotes that I had about Hank and apply them to the way Shesty's playing right now. I mean, we're truly spoiled. The guy's unbelievable. Been our best player all year. At this point, nothing really surprises me. He's just otherworldly. I don't know. I don't think there are any superlatives left for him. He's that good. It really is incredible. I was just really hoping he was going to get his first tonight.
And, I know that the goal is to win every night, obviously. But when do you look at the standings, see where you are, see where
we know the division's competitive and incredibly tight, but for us, it's focusing on things we can control. I don't think you can look at the big picture when you're in the middle of an 82-game season. You got to take it one day at a time, like the old cliche says.
Chris,